Assalamualaikum. I am Widi Mutakin from Expos Academy. When making drawings or illustrations, we often need to make long lines or curves. Or at least, when making line art, we want to keep our hands steady. For this purpose, there are at least four methods that we can do in Krita. The first is by rotating or mirroring the canvas. The second is by using the brush smoothing feature. The third is by using the assistant tool. And the last one is by utilizing vector graphics. Let's discuss all these methods one by one. For our practice material, I have sketched this teapot character of the record. To make the sketch less prominent, we can lower the opacity to around 25%. Then press Insert to create a new pin layer on top. The first method that artists often rely on when creating long lines or curves is by rotating the canvas and/or by mirroring it. This is because most people have a tendency to be good at drawing lines in a certain direction, whether it is left diagonal or right diagonal, or perhaps vertical or horizontal directions. By rotating the canvas in a certain orientation, we can overcome our weaknesses and create lines in the direction that we like or are good at. Just for example, for me, drawing a line vertically from top to bottom is easier compared to drawing a line that extends horizontally. If I have to draw a horizontal line, I usually rotate the canvas around 90 degrees first, then I draw the line. Alright, so now, how do we rotate the canvas? There are many ways to rotate the canvas in Krita. If you prefer the middle mouse button method, you can hold down the shift key and then click drag with the middle mouse button. If you prefer the spacebar navigation technique, you can hold down the spacebar key as well as the shift key, then click drag with the regular left mouse button. If you prefer to use only the keyboard keys without the mouse, you can press number 4 and number 6 to rotate the canvas around, and press 5 on the keyboard to reset the orientation. If you prefer to use the UI buttons, you can use this small circle at the bottom area on the status bar. Or you may also use the pop-up palette, that is, by right-clicking while using the brush tool, then drag and rotate this small white circle. To reset or return the canvas rotation to default, you can slide and snap this white circle to the dark circle on top. There is actually another method to rotate the canvas, and that is by using touch gesture. If you are using an Android device, for example, or using a drawing tablet that supports touch gesture, you can use two fingers to rotate the canvas and also zoom. You can also use three fingers to do panning. Unfortunately, I don't currently have a device that supports touch gestures, so I cannot show it. Next, to mirror the canvas, you can press the letter M on the keyboard, or you can also press Alt M. The difference is that by pressing the letter M only, the canvas will be mirrored at the center of it. But with the Alt M shortcut, the canvas will be mirrored at the location of the mouse cursor. Besides keyboard shortcuts, you can also access them via the pop-up palette. Just make sure the buttons below are active and press this icon to perform mirror. If you are interested, you can download this PDF file for free. I will leave a link in the description area below. Just a reminder, if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss future tutorials. And please help me grow this channel by clicking the like button. Thank you. When you use the freehand brush tool, in the tool options docker, you will see the brush smoothing option. There are four options provided by Krita: none, basic, weighted, and stabilizer. The none option is the default option, which basically means that the brush smoothing feature is turned off. You should know that the brush smoothing feature will put more load on your computer's performance. So in general, you always want to turn this option off. You should turn it on only when it is necessary. For example, when creating outlines or line art, or what is commonly known as the inking process in comic creation. Next, this basic option is actually only necessary if you are using an older model drawing tablet. Today, most drawing tablets available in the market already have a basic brush smoothing feature embedded in the hardware and or the driver. You can simulate the feature via software with this basic option. If you enable this basic option but do not feel any difference, it means that your drawing tablet already has the feature enabled. You've been using it all along, whether you realize it or not. The next option, called weighted, will give a stronger brush smoothing effect than the basic, of course, with the consequence of more burden on your computer system. With this feature, you may notice that the brush tip is moving late compared to the mouse cursor. This is to compensate for the vibration of your hand. Due to time constraints, I cannot cover all the parameters in this video. The fourth option, stabilizer, has an even stronger smoothing effect compared to the weighted mode. Consequently, it also makes the heaviest demand on computer performance. Generally, I am quite satisfied with the weighted mode and rarely need to use the stabilizer mode. The third method is to utilize the assistant tool. In the real world, we usually rely on straight rulers, French curves, compasses, and other similar tools to draw long lines or curves. Well, we can think of the assistant tool in Krita as these drawing tools. There are many types of assistants provided by Krita. Let's try the ellipse type for now. Click on the canvas at three locations to create the ellipse shape. After you are done, you can still adjust the points. If the point is covered, you can simply zoom in until it is visible. Then, for this large curved line, we can use the spline type instead. Click on the starting point, then click on the end point, and then click to determine the location of the first hand, then the location of the second hand. As usual, we can still adjust these control points if needed. Alright, to utilize the assistance, when we use the brush tool, in the tool options docker, make sure this snap to assistance option is active. There are many parameters that we can set, but let's just leave them to the default. As you can see, I can easily draw lines that follow the assistant objects that we created earlier. If you want to see your drawing more clearly, you can go to the View menu, then disable the Show Painting Assistance option. I use a custom shortcut for this option, which is the quotation mark. Please note that what we have discussed here is just a small part of what you can do with the assistance and the brush tool in Krita. If you want to learn Krita completely and systematically from very basic to advanced, you need to check out my Krita courses at www.exposacademy.com. The fourth method to draw smooth lines or curves is to not draw them. That is, not drawing them manually, but using vector graphics. To be able to use vector in Krita, we need to create a vector layer first. If we have a vector layer active, automatically all of these drawing tools will produce vector shapes, except of course the brush tools. Just for an example, we can start by creating the circle area above with the ellipse tool. Because we want to create only the outline, we need to change the fill option to not filled. And for the outline option, we've set it to brush. Because of this setting, the vector line will be black, which is based on the foreground color used by the brush tool. And the thickness of the outline will also follow the size of the active brush. So, if we click drag to create the ellipse, we can see that the outline is quite thick. To change the appearance of the vector shape, first, you need to activate the Select Shape tool. Make sure the shape is selected. Then, in the Tool Options docker, in the Outline tab, we can adjust the thickness by clicking on the thickness field, then turning the scroll wheel up or down. You can also still change its transformation, including its scale, rotation, and position. This is one of the advantages of using vector. Let's just set the thickness to 6 pixels. To make sure the next outline we create will also start at 6 pixels, we can right-click on this field, type 6, and then enter. Next, let's try another tool, say the Bezier Curve tool. Click here, click drag at the top of the curve, then click again on the bottom right, then press enter to confirm. It will take too long to finish everything, but at least we can create another line below so that later we have a closed area that we can fill with color. And let's also create the two eye lines. You can use the Edit Shapes tool if you want to adjust or revise the shape. Okay, now you might be wondering, what if we want to create a variable width outline, or in other words, a non-uniform outline thickness? To do this, we can just add white filled vector shapes to reduce the outline area, and we can use black ones to add more outline areas. For example, we want to remove or tidy up this center area. Use the Bezier Curve tool as before, but set the fill option to background color, which is currently white, and we set the outline to no outline. Then just create an area to cover the lines that we don't want. Another example, we want to tidy up this curve part. Just create another vector shape all the way to the intersection of the line on the right. Yes, it's not perfect yet, but you get the idea. Indeed, to be able to do this, you must first know the basic techniques of using vector in Krita. Next, let's try the opposite, and that is, we want to add more of the outline area. For example, at this corner, simply change the fill option to foreground color because it is currently black. And just create a sharp shape in this corner. Another example, we want the intersection of these lines to be more curved. And so on. Alright? Next, if we hide the background layer, we can see that the vector shapes we created earlier are solid white, not transparent. The black color doesn't matter. We just want the white area to be transparent. There are many ways we can do this. One of them is to first apply a filter mask to the vector layer. Then, for the filter type, we choose gradient map. By default, the active preset is foreground to transparent. If this is not active, you can activate the preset from here. Or just make sure that the left stop is solid black and the right stop is fully transparent. Click OK. And now, due to this filter mask, all the white colors have turned transparent. Again, because it is a filter mask, you can show or hide the effect non-destructively. From here, you can easily add color to the drawing. Previously in this channel, I covered how to add color using the colorize mask feature. For now, I will just use the regular fill tool. Create a new pin layer, then use the fill tool. You can also press the letter F on the keyboard if you want. We need another color other than black, for example, this reddish orange color. Make sure that the reference mode is set to all layers, and click inside the closed area to fill in the color. If you are interested in learning more about the vector feature and how to combine it with the raster feature to create illustrations quickly, you can join my course, Digital Painting with Krita 5 Intermediate Level. Or, if you are interested in learning other computer graphics software, you can go to my website at www.exposacademy.com. Again, don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss any future tutorials. Please share this video and give it a thumbs up if you like it. If you want to request a tutorial about Krita or other graphics software, just write in the comment section below what topics you want me to cover. I hope this video can be useful. Wassalamualaikum.